Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. I want to talk about and or statements in probability. If I say the probability of A or B, then what I'm saying is that in this single trial of this experiment, what is the probability of A or B or both A and B occurring? So let's say I want to roll a six-sided die, and event A is I roll a 1, or B, I roll a 6. Then the probability of A or B would be the probability of A plus the probability of B. And I have a 1 in 6 chance of rolling a 1 and a 1 in 6 chance of rolling a 6. So I have 2 out of 6, or 0.333 is the probability for rolling in a 1 or a 6. Okay, this works because 1 in 6 are what we call disjoint events, which means they cannot occur at the same time. So if I'm talking about the probability of two things occurring, and neither one can occur at the same time, I just have to add those two probabilities together. We can say that 1 in 6 are mutually exclusive because they cannot both occur at the same time. So when you have mutually exclusive events or disjoint events, it's very easy to find the probability for an or statement. But be careful, because what if I said my event A was I roll an even number and my event B was I roll a 4? This would be an example of two events that are not disjoint, because one of them can happen at the same time, right? One or more of them mean disjoint in general means that one or more of the events can occur simultaneously. So 4 is an even number. So if I just looked at the probability separately like I did above, I would end up counting 4 twice. Because if I looked at the probability of getting an even number, 4 would be included. And if I looked at the probability of getting a 4, then I would already be looking at that twice. So then we have what we call the addition rule. And the addition rule says to find the probability of A or B, then you take the probability of A plus the probability of B, and then you subtract the probability of that overlap, which we didn't do before because there is no overlap between rolling a 1 and a 6. But if you don't have disjoint events, then you have to figure in that overlap. So the probability of A and B means the probability that you roll an even number and it is a 4. So that's what this overlap is, that you rolled your even number and that even number happens to be a 4. So to get this probability using the addition rule, we would say the probability of A, which there's 3 evens out of every 6, so that's half, or 0.5. The probability of B, which is rolling a 4, 1 in 6 chance. And then the probability of rolling an even number that is a 4, and there's 1 in 6 chance of that. And so this should be subtraction right here, because we're subtracting off that part that is an overlap. So you can see that our final probability is just half, because 4 is already represented in that even number thing. So it really doesn't affect anything. So we would still have a probability of 0.500 when we looked at that. So we really want to think about, is our event disjoint or not before we start calculating the probability. For complementary events, the events are necessarily disjoint, because if event A happens, then we say the complement of A means that A is not happening. So when we look at the probability of A or complement of A happening, that probability is 1. That means that that probability is a certain event. Either A or not A is going to happen. Which of the following would be considered disjoint events? Selecting a band student and selecting a football player. Selecting an honor student and selecting a student on academic probation. Selecting a teacher and selecting a woman. Selecting a teenager and selecting someone over 40. Remember, disjoint events are events that cannot happen simultaneously. Look at the first one, selecting a band student and selecting a football player. Is it possible somebody could play in the band and be on the football team? Yes. Those are not disjoint events because they could happen. Somebody could be in both of those sets. What about the second one? Is it possible to be an honor student and at the same time be on academic probation? Probably not. And since those two things cannot happen for the same person simultaneously, then those would be considered to be disjoint. What about selecting a teacher and selecting a woman? Could you be a teacher and a woman at the same time? Woman teacher talking, right? So yes, you can be both of those. Those are not disjoint. Selecting a teenager and selecting someone over 40. Those are two different things. You can't be a teenager and be over 40 at the same time. So those are disjoint events. A and C are not disjoint because someone could be in both of those at the same time. Okay, that's all for this video. We'll talk about more probability later. Have a great day.